The Charleston County School District says they need more money to be competitive, but they don't have a way to get it. So they are turning to state legislators for help. News 2's Macy McLeod has more on how this could impact your tax dollars.
Brendan, this is what CCSD says the problem is. They don't get a lot of money from the state because Charleston is a richer district. And the idea is they can get more money they need from their tax base or the people who live here. But because of something called Act 388, they are limited on how much they can tax locally. So they aren't able to make up this difference between state and local money, which means cuts to jobs and programs.
The state requires us to raise salaries each year. This past year that cost us about $6.7 million just to raise them for teachers. We only got about $2.5 to $3 million from the state for that because of our wealth.
And with no additional money coming in locally, that means jobs were cut and class sizes increased.
For this year, we cut about $18 million and it was all positions.
Right now, homeowners who live in their homes are not taxed for schools. It only applies to businesses, rental properties, and secondary homes. The district's CFO says they don't want that to change, but they want the ability to have a higher increase in taxes on those who already pay it.
To repeal the formula for the raising of the taxes, not to put any taxes on the homeowners. The homeowners would pay zero. They would not pay any more at all. But we would have the ability to have more flexibility to raise taxes.
Basically, they want to adjust the rules to allow more leeway on taxes when there are mandatory salary increases. According to a report from the district, more than 80% of their budget is salaries and benefits. So they take a hard hit when the state requires higher salaries but doesn't put up the money. So they want the salary increase to be factored in when determining how much they are allowed to raise taxes.
We're trying to get up there with using that percentage of increase in salary expenses, you know, personnel costs, plus the CPI, and they could put a ceiling on that, and that would generate more taxes for us and thereby more revenue.
The school board will vote on Monday to approve a resolution that would be sent to the state asking them to change Act 388 to include those increased personnel costs in the calculations for tax increases. Macy McLeod, News 2.